So post-importation duty refund is that famous 19 U.S.C. United States Code 1520D statute. I know that CBP examiners keep telling us that you do not need to bring statutory stuff with you. You are all your, well, besides the material such as directives and CBP form 7501 instructions, you pretty much the main core text is Code of Federal Regulations Title 19, and the length of it varies. Sometimes it's 1 through 200. Sometimes they take it all the way from 0 to the end, from the beginning to the end. But of course, harmonized tariff schedule of the United States, which deals with primarily with classification, but also, as we learned throughout this class, it also deals with free trade agreements, application of general notes, etc., etc. Now, post-importation, so this 1520D statute, it deals with multiple free trade agreements, which includes NAFTA. So let me take a moment and pull up the statute, so we are on the same page of what we are talking about. All right, so here the 1520D is this little paragraph over here, and as you can see, it includes NAFTA, right? North American Free Trade Agreement, but it also includes a lot of other free trade agreements. You see Oman, Peru, Korea, Colombia, Panama, and as we discussed other free trade agreements, we saw the application of this being tested out of the blue, because that provision kind of with time, as customs updates their Code of Federal Regulations, some agreements implemented, some are still being in process, but customs still expect you to know about this statutory provision. And they expect you to know this in a way, one way, through just know it, period. And another way to know this is, at least in the context of NAFTA, one way to know this is because this 1520D has been implemented into the Code of Federal Regulations, 181 Code of Federal Regulations, subpart D. So, for example, this talks about the post-importation duty refund claim, the substance of it, and 181.32 takes you through the filing procedure. Notice, usually, if you are familiar with in dealing with CFR, usually you have the statute which authorizes this regulation. Here they haven't done that, but that's okay. This is why we take this class, is to know what is associated with what. So 19 U.S.C. 1520D, also sometimes referred to as Section 520D of the Tariff Act as amended. All right, so this is one of the same things. And what it says is the requirement for filing the post-importation duty refund claim, timing requirement, is 1 year after the date of importation. Now, of course, the buzzword here is not only 1 year, but after the date of importation. Date of importation. And date of importation is really like a term of art. Recall, we talked about date of entry to some extent. No, we are. This is not date of entry. This is date of importation. And the good source of reference to find out the meaning of the of the day of the date of importation and how it is defined is, in my view, is provided under the CBP Form 7501 instructions, which is a required, which is a required material for this exam. So I believe, let's see. Country of origin, import date. So it would be under the import date rubric. So notice the how CBP defines, how customs defines date of importation. They break it down if it's by vessel, if it's by other than vessel. So mostly we're talking about the air shipments. If it goes in by the ocean, we're talking about once the vessel arrived within the port limits, within the limits of US port with intent to unlade. So there is several more provisions. So one element is there must be a vessel. Another one, there must be limits of the US port. And another thing, there must be intent to unlade, which can be shown through through the shipping documents such as the bill of lading. The air shipments, we're talking about arrival within the US port limits. So see, the intent to unlade prong is kind of missing over here. Whether it's relevant or not, I'm not certain if it plays that much that big of a deal on a customs broker exam, but it that definition is out there. Generally speaking, once it arrives within US port limits, then the airport limits with airway bill of lading showing the US as a final destination, or seaport limits with seaway bill of lading showing the United States as the final destination, or really the country of import or maybe the transit country, then we're good. So back to the outline. So 1 year is one element and date of importation in another. So let's take a look at several ways CBP examiners can test you on this. So first question deals with the importer of that good and when it may file a claim for a refund of any excess duty within the what time frame. And we're talking, you know, the here the call of the question is the scope of the question deals with the post-importation duty refund claim, right? And another buzzword is NAFTA here, right? And of course, we're talking about the time frame, so we know the what customs examiners are looking for. They're looking for 1 year after the date of importation. And here comes the answer, 1 year after the date of importation, which is the correct answer choice. A is a good pick for this one. 180 days after liquidation days deals with the protest. So we're not dealing with a protest, we're dealing with a post-importation duty refund. And it used to be that one could be the substitute of another. Then there were several court cases that came out, which confused the whole thing. Then customs, based on that court cases, issued a directive. Then the directive was the directive was challenged in another court decision. So now it's kind of all confusing. I think well, you have to look at the law. There is a methodology to that as well. For the customs broker exam purposes, customs examiners will usually make it really clear which one they're testing you on, protest or post 1520D provision, post-importation duty refund. So B is incorrect. D, 90 days after the liquidation date. It used to be that protest before the Miscellaneous Act of 2004 had 90 days, but that changed after 2004 to 180 days. So 90 days is also incorrect. 1 year after the liquidation date of the entry summary. No, we know that time of entry is relevant for the purposes of the protest, for example, but it's importation date, date of import, that is relevant for the purposes of the 1520D post-importation duty refund claim. Claim can only be made at the time of entry. It's a good practice to have it made at time of entry, but if you do not have that certificate of origin, NAFTA certificate of origin, CBP form 434, then you are legally are not allowed to do this, and if you do, you can be subject to penalties. So E is incorrect, A is good.